points on the list. Leaving it here, but I still get a spread. Started with a little, but I still reinvest it. Fear how I feel, then you feel less blessed. I just want the lesson, I just want protection. I'm up and I'm down, but the sound like progression. Farmer never plans if he waits for perfection. Finger to the down, hold it.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, I got your watch list coming in at January 3rd, 2022. And the stock market is back, ladies and gentlemen. I got good news and bad news. The good news, we're probably going to get a lot of volume this week. Everybody is coming back. We're going to see a lot of positioning. We are even going to get some earnings and a lot of data. So that is the good part. The bad part, most of the other markets are going to be closed tomorrow. So I believe Hong Kong, Japan, China, Australia, and even the UK, they are all closed the day after. We will be open. So things may get off to a slow start. We will see again day after Christmas. Even with a lot of things closed, we were able to rally. So we are going to find out what happens. But we are starting the new year. A lot of different things happening, a lot of different asset classes. Even where we close, I got a couple of pretty pictures for you. But the positioning and how we move forward this week, it can get exciting. So I hope you're ready. But a lot of you have been here for a while, so you need to drop that thumbs up. And hopefully we see you on stream, youtube.com/thestockmarket. But we need your help, baby. Today is Sunday, tomorrow is Monday. That is usually how it works, but this is the random account generator. So on this watch list, what we ask from you is that you post a random option trade, keep it below $100, post the strike price, expiration date, all of that good stuff. Tomorrow morning before the market, we're going to do a random comment picker and see what happens. So we are up from the initial 500, but take a look at the year today. It's a pretty interesting one, Chad. So let's start the year off right and post one, and thank you. But coming into the keys, as far as what we're going to get this week, you are getting the new year. Again, a lot of excitement and positioning. That is one thing we're really going to be watching this week. But again, the holidays tomorrow. Tomorrow's pretty much going to be a coin toss. My expectation is that the volume will be a little bit lower, so it'll be a little bit slower. But doesn't mean we can't move a lot. So that's the first thing I'm looking at. But as far as the data that you're going to be getting this week, not only are you going to have a couple of earnings, and even Walgreens is on that list, but then you're also getting the jobs report, the Fed minutes, the ISM manufacturing, ISM services, another ADP jobs report, and then the auto sales. And you've already probably heard the news with Tesla. It was absolutely epic, but all the auto companies were going to get a lot of data. So if you think about the last couple weeks, remember with the holidays, the news was slow, the data was slow. So now things should start to pick up. And do not forget, you have the Fed down the road here pretty much in 3 weeks. So keep that in mind. But coming into your first pretty picture here, what this is showing you is a record that has never happened before in the stock market. So obviously, we're starting a new year, but at the close of 2021, you had all 11 industries of the stock market in the green, and that has never happened before. So depending on the winners and losers, a lot of people are going to be keeping their eye out for, okay, how do people start to position? Do they keep going after the winners here? Where do they start to move? And again, a lot of these industries we've been talking about, like healthcare, financials, and even energy, these are going to be key to watch here, because if we get any rotation, you could start to see how investors are feeling coming into a pretty uncertain year so far. And then by the end of this week or maybe next week, you're going to start getting your year-end estimates from economists. They're going to start at the beginning of the year, and they're going to say, well, I expect the S&P to be here. So far, we've already got a couple. The divergence is absolutely wild, but we will see how that plays out here over the next week or so. But coming into tomorrow, we've been talking about this, and this is one thing to start the year off I'm really going to be watching, especially this year, and especially if you saw what happened last year. We really need to watch the bonds. So I keep saying, watch how investors position. We got to watch all these industries and all that good stuff, but just see how people start off the year, especially with bonds and the Fed 3 weeks out. We may see the floodgates open in one direction or the other. I did make a play on it. We kind of have both ways over the last couple weeks, but again, just what happened last year, and it makes sense with this year positioning and everything going on. Pretty much leading into this year, or right when it started, you did start to get a pretty big move, and then from there, and by the end of this first month, the bonds just really did something unexpected. So where we ended the year, it's quite an interesting level. We've been watching a lot of back and forth, even on the Thursdays and Fridays, you've been noticing more correlation between the S&P 500 and bonds. So as we kick off the new year here, this is actually going to be a pretty big focus. I know a lot of people always like to ask about the TLT play. It may be there again. Just the point is, pay attention to it. There will probably be a lot more volatility in bonds over this next 30 days, but pretty much here is the starting point. So that's what we need to watch. But coming into the company news and events now, there wasn't too much over the weekend. Again, there was a lot of Omicron headlines and stuff like that. A lot of the Omicron, both positive and negative. Some people were warning against it, but if you've been noticing, a lot of COVID guidelines have been slowly getting chipped away at, and there's a lot of things of pretty much people are calming down, especially with the death rates not going up. So there was still a lot of those headlines. We got like work from home data or work from home announcements from JP Morgan, Goldman, all of that. We even saw it last week, but pretty much all the banks are going work from home. So it's a little bit sticky. The only big piece of news, and now this time it wasn't from COVID, it was because of the weather, but there was a lot more of these weekend flight cancellations, over 3,000 in total. And if you remember, I believe the week after Christmas, it was about 5,000, and that's kind of how we started off last Monday. So keep your eye out for that. It may be a little bit sticky. This one was because of weather, so we'll see how things play out, but watch that. And the travel stocks, and then AT&T and Verizon, they have rejected the U.S. call for delay for 5G, so they won the bid, they got the airwaves and all of that, and they're looking to implement it. They said they'd be cool with a six-month delay, but the government has been asking for them to kind of slow it down because it could interfere with airlines and aircraft, so the company said no. I feel like we've heard about 5G for a while, but now it's like starting to get rolled out, but we'll see how that plays out. Watch both of those names tomorrow, again, especially in terms of positioning, value, and how they ended last year. And then coming into Tesla, this number was absolutely epic. They revved up their deliveries. They even beat their past record. They did 308,000 electric vehicles delivered in fourth quarter, and it brings them to about like 926,000 on the year. I think it's like 40% higher year over year, and they had a great year last year. So I'm really impressed with the numbers. This was good. You're going to see a lot of movement on Tesla tomorrow, but there was also sub numbers like even Li Auto. They had good delivery numbers, and then you're going to get the auto sales this week. So be prepared for a lot of moves just within the automotive industry. We might see a lot of different plays there, but that was a big piece of news. And then OPEC, they are going to have a meeting this week. They are surprisingly expected to increase supply. So we'll see how that plays out. Again, oil is back to Omicron levels, and energy was the leading industry in 2021. So let's see how we start this off. But again, OPEC and all of that, it shouldn't be more drama-filled, but in general, we just got to watch what happens with energy, oil prices, and all of that. And then CES, that is kicking off on Wednesday, and we actually might get some plays from it. It's a shortened CES. I think it's only going to last for a couple days there, and a lot of companies are doing it remotely. They're not showing up, but sometimes we get announcements and all that, and I think AMD is making an announcement. I don't know if it's at CES or not, but they may have a product line there, so watch out for that this week. And then Airbus, this is a pretty interesting one. I want to see if this trend continues here into the new year, but as of 2021, Airbus sold more airplanes than Boeing. This is pretty wild news, especially if you know the history with it. So keep your eye out for this and watch to see if this trend continues for the next quarter there. It could show that Boeing has some value, but then also if this is like Airbus taking market share, we saw AMD and Intel, so we'll see what happens. But there was that. And then finally, the Colorado wildfires, they have not identified a source yet. So we made a small $100 play on this one. Again, there was a lot of movement and the energy companies there were tripping out, but it looks like it may have started from a different source and not the power line. So keep that in mind. People are going to be watching that. We'll see. And again, a lot of different weather events and headlines was surprisingly pretty apparent here. And again, even last year, beginning of the year, we did get a lot of different weather events, but you saw it affected more companies and not necessarily the whole index. So very straightforward. It's all about the new year and positioning. It's going to be exciting. A lot of things have the ability to move, and maybe we get a head start with everything closed. So I hope you're ready, but that is pretty much it. So let us get into the plays. So right off that bat, I got three or four different stocks that I'm looking at coming into tomorrow. I actually did make quite a few plays on Friday, but I really am looking for positioning. So the first set of plays I'm going to be looking at, Roblox and Airbnb. Why? Because I'm biased and I love these names, but you saw last year, again, the last quarter there, even though some of them came down, these were the outperformers. They are all expected to pretty much have a lot riding on their earnings here. And again, keep earnings in mind, but I want to see, okay, these ones were kind of outperforming in growth. They held up on the year. Let's see how people treat them on Monday, but I want to see if we see some quick positioning back into some of those names. Some of them even held. Remember, Friday was not the best day. It was kind of chill. Then we had that weird sell-off, but a lot of tech sold off. And again, you were down about 0.5% on the NASDAQ. So any names that hold up kind of did highlight it. Roblox was one of those. Again, we have those older plays. If you guys remember, we went after the Nancy play. We still got that one, and that one is up about 15%. And then I think that other one, it was fluctuating between 5. Remember, we got this before, but that came down and then still riding out our share. So keep in mind their earnings and everything happening. But that is the first set of plays I'm going to be watching. Then coming into the second set, Amazon, I did make a play on this one. It's a little bit bigger here. We've been talking about day trading it. I thought it would have a move on Friday, but even coming into the new year, I wanted to hold some. But the real big thesis behind this play, their earnings is just in a couple weeks. So I'm going to trade it a couple times. And again, it's super, super risky because even if there is earnings, if anything happens, it could definitely throw us off that earnings trail with the premium. Sometimes it holds, but if you're really early, you can get ultra clapped on there. So I'm going to be taking the risk, but that's one thing I'm keeping in mind, making sure I get enough time to cover the earnings and pretty much trying to play these moves. So if we start off the year with tech kind of being hot and the bonds don't go too crazy again, that's the only thing I'm worried about. There was a lot of that bond movement on Friday, or more so the correlation, and we've been talking about flattening yield curve versus not. So that's one of the big things I'm watching for. But I do think Amazon has some potential. We even do have those Shopify plays as well. But as far as the play, I made this one on Friday. I grabbed the February 3700 calls. I bought one for 3800, down 12%, but since it's a big contract, it's about $500. So this is what I'm saying, I was going for the flip. Again, Friday ended up just being a total dud. I'm willing to hold this a little bit because, again, before we know it, we are going to have earnings. So going to be watching those. I may even be down to grab another one. I just want to see the chains. And again, how do things open up tomorrow? But that is the second play. And then the third play, Tesla. It might be a good one, baby. I really, really did like the news. Again, those numbers were huge. I'm actually impressed. And on top of it, like I said earlier, there's a lot of different EV companies that have already reported. So that could be just an overall positive vibe for all of them this week, along with auto sales. So if you get a lot of good macro data or data on the industry, it could help out. But I think Tesla, I just want to see how it moves. I don't know if I'm going to make a play. There's probably a high chance I look at it in the morning, and if the premiums are too high, I'm going to be like, nah, man, I can't do it. But I think it's going to be important. If we get good momentum in the market, this one could be an absolute killer. So watch out for them. And then finally, this one's a weird play. A lot of people have talked to us about it, but the reason why I like it, beginning of the year, and it has underperformed and it gives it value. But PayPal, essentially, they have been the worst performer on the S&P in 2021, and it's their worst sell-off since they spun off from eBay in 2015. So overall, they've been getting clapped there again ever since like the Pinterest stuff. They were already doing bad, and then it just kind of pummeled even Square a little bit. But I think there might be value in here. I just want to see how people treat it. If it does get exciting tomorrow, there might be a play within that one. So those were the main plays as far as everything else. I got a couple names I'm looking at, some I didn't make plays on, but I did do a couple of plays Friday. We still have that one weekly. That one's a little bit clapped. Or was that one on Friday? No, it was day before. But then I opened up Friday with TBT. So if bond yields or TLT drops, these will profit. I grabbed the February $20 calls for 15. So spent about like $300, kept it a little bit smaller, but wanted some of that exposure. Those ended up dropping. I bought them early in the morning. They were holding the price. The premiums are just wide. It's pretty stubborn. Essentially, we either get velocity or not, and if you don't, you will lose on that play. Then I got the Amazon and then Affirm. Remember these ones? We were up like 50% on them. I sold two out of the three at 265, 50% gain. Holding that one again. That one covers earnings. Then XCL, that was the small one related to the fires. And then I did a $20 daily on Envax. They submitted their application for emergency use here in the state, so that one got a little bit hype, but then it quickly sold off. But those are going to be the main plays as far as everything else. Again, Roblox, Airbnb, that's one to watch. And then even Walgreens, they are going to be reporting, I believe, Wednesday or Thursday, so they're going to be at an interesting spot. This one's going to be all about the premiums. I have even been watching it. Remember, we made that flip on there, so the premiums are already kind of high. It's a little bit tricky here so far. We may burn one for earnings, but just watch how it opens up. Again, this is a high dividend in value names. So we'll see how that plays out. Watch out for Disney again. They were kind of a leader last week. They finally chilled out, and it was one of those Nancy plays, and they also underperformed here on the year. So watch how they kind of open up here, especially with earnings right around the corner. Walmart, they came alive. Those premiums that we have are still up 20. Remember, I kept one of them, but they're still going up, and maybe to start the year here, I mean, they're almost at break even. So it's a pretty good spot. We'll see how they watch. I would definitely keep an eye out for them this week. Even Ford, even though you're going to be getting a lot of EV news with Tesla, even Lucid, or even Lee Automotive. But I like how Ford played. Again, we made a lot of those flips. This one could be a very exciting one, and I'm actually really liking them even here for this year. So watch out for that. Tesla, like we said, going to check the premiums, and then Airbnb holding very nice. Again, even on the 1 year too, it's kind of pretty much slightly above where we started. So this is a good one. Again, it's playing in between some key levels. Again, there could be a lot of plays with this one, but give it a week or so. We'll watch how tomorrow plays out if it does get exciting, but the real move may start to be earnings on this one. And then Roblo, like we said, and then Aeson, this is one of those people sold it off. They closed up pretty decent. They were up a lot more on Friday. The contracts are willing to move, but essentially if we start the year and people want to get back into software, these ones may be very, very fire. So going to be watching that. Square also has a sympathy there to PayPal. They kind of move the same. And then the banks, remember, we got a couple of big plays on there. I'm still liking it. Again, depending on what bonds do here, we could get some big moves. And beginning of last year, this was their opportunity. So watch out for the banks. Those will be hot. Again, Lee Automotive, they did good delivery numbers like Tesla, but theirs is up like 100% or like 50%. So I'm not really the biggest fan, pretty much. I'm just going to watch the health of all of these EV names tomorrow and see if it could lend more credence to some other play. And then NVIDIA, still in there. Watch even AMD again with CS and all that. We'll see if these come up. They've done good, but they've kind of just remained neutral. So keep that in mind. And then coming into TLT and the dollar, all we got to do is just see how we open up. Do we get some movements? Not ironically enough, you're right at this level. It's pretty much equilibrium. If the dollar does make a big move, that will be key. Again, you have been watching it drop a little bit. So the dollar breaks out of the range first. Maybe it could lend to us calming down. But I really do think bonds are going to be the big show here. So keep your eye out for them. Watch who takes the first step and make sure you get off to a running start for the first day of the year, baby. But that is your watch list, ladies and gentlemen. Make sure Hydra Healthy ready to go. Make sure post your watch list. Make sure we see you there in the morning. I need the armor on. I need the helmet shot. I need to remember there's a tree of life, baby. But Nicole loves you. I love you. And we'll see you in the morning. Let's go.